This presentation focuses on the proposed campus expansion of the Hsi Lai Temple in Hacienda Heights and its potential impacts to the Puente-Chino Hills Wildlife Corridor. This presentation covers five critical topics: the Puente-Chino Hills Wildlife Corridor, wildlife movement choke points, the proposed Hsi Lai Temple project, the project's status, and the potential next steps. There are more than 19,000 acres of protected natural lands in the Puente-Chino Hills Wildlife Corridor in four Southern California counties: Los Angeles, Orange, Riverside, and San Bernardino. The Wildlife Corridor spans 31 miles between the 60 and 605 freeways in Whittier to the 91 and 71 freeways in Corona. The Hsi Lai Temple project is shown with the purpley-pink dot above the words Puente Hills Preserve. This area, and most of this state, is part of the California Floristic Province and is home to many unique plant and animal species called biodiversity. Some of the species found in the corridor are on this slide and range from the top predator like the cougar to prey species like deer, as well as songbirds like the California gnatcatcher and insects like the monarch butterfly. These wildlife species survive in the hillside system because of the diverse array of plant species and communities. These include black walnut, sycamore, and oak woodlands, as well as important chaparral and coastal sage shrub plants like buckwheat and prickly pear cactus. There are an abundance of wildflowers, especially in spring, like the California poppy and lupin. Next up in the presentation are wildlife movement choke points within the Puente-Chino Hills Wildlife Corridor. The Puente-Chino Hills Wildlife Corridor has four key movement areas across the landscape. These include the bottom right, Coal Canyon, near the center, Tonner Canyon, left of center, Harbor Boulevard, and on the left, Hacienda Boulevard. Each of these locations serves a critical role in allowing wildlife to move from one natural area to another. Two of these movement areas have been protected already. Coal Canyon was protected in 2000 and 2001 by adding land to Chino Hills State Park and connecting the park to the Santa Ana Mountains. These lands had been slated for development, both residential and commercial, on both sides of the 91 freeway. The land was valued at a whopping $63.5 million because the majority of the land was entitled for development. On the west side of the hills, the connection at Harbor Boulevard was restored through the addition of a culvert under the roadway. This $1 million investment guided animals to the culvert and reduced vehicle collisions with wildlife. Near the Hsi Lai Temple, the wildlife crossing under Hacienda Boulevard is supposed to be used as a recreation tunnel for hikers, bikers, and equestrians to keep them off the road as well. Unfortunately, this design is really targeted toward use by people, which dissuades wildlife from using the tunnel. Consequently, wildlife are already less likely to use the tunnel because it is long, dark, narrow, and being used by humans. The Hsi Lai Temple project is a proposed expansion across the street from the existing facility on the west side of the hills. Let's dive into this expansion. The temple was built to serve as a spiritual and cultural center. The site is constructed on the east side of Hacienda Boulevard and sits on roughly 11 acres. The owners also purchased land immediately across the street on the west side of Hacienda Boulevard. The expansion site is roughly 29 acres of hillside land, nearly three times the size of the existing facility. The project site is in pink, adjacent to lands owned and managed by the Puente Hills Habitat Preservation Authority. This land is named Arroyo San Miguel Preserve, and it sits adjacent to the proposed expansion. Recently, the Habitat Authority restored portions of the preserve to improve coastal sage shrub communities and create habitat for the endangered California gnatcatcher and coastal cactus wren. The expansion includes 17 new buildings, the renovation of a house into a dorm, two driveways on South Hacienda Boulevard, and a seven-level subterranean garage carved into the hillside. This view shows the existing temple in pale orange, the new project expansion in pink across the street, and the protected or easement lands in yellow. This aerial also gives a great depiction of the hilly landscape and steep topography of the proposed expansion. The land is governed by the Los Angeles County General Plan and is designated as rural land RL2 with the zoning of light and heavy agriculture. The proposal would modify the land use designation to institutional, which matches the existing facility across the street. There are also multiple compliance areas being watched, including but not limited to the Hacienda Heights Community Plan, the Hillside Management Area Ordinance, and the Hillside Design Guidelines. Based on the project's initial study, we know that the proposed expansion will need at least four permits: oak tree removal, grading, conditional use, and encroachment. Now, after years of operation, the temple wants to expand the facilities and events, which will increase traffic on already congested intersections and a road known for multiple closures due to unstable slopes. The proposal will also add a new traffic signal, creating three signals within a quarter mile of one another. The proposal will also increase wildfire ignition risks by adding flammable material at the edge of the wildlands. The buildings sprawl across the landscape, requiring additional fuel modification and adding more concrete. Further, it bulldozes significant ridgelines, ignoring existing protections in the Hacienda Heights Community Plan. After a quick review of the area's geology, the Puente Hills are clearly prone to landslides, including this location. The proposal also disrupts the existing Shabaram Trail, forcing trail users to find other routes. As part of the early environmental review of the proposed expansion, a biological constraints analysis was completed. The proposal to expand the site degrades important habitat for sensitive species by modifying the natural topography, forcing wildlife off the property. Investments made by the public and private entities to date include over $215 million. That's why organizations and individuals are concerned about this project. The public investment is at risk because of a private project. Construction of the project would reduce habitat for high-value resources, including plants and animals such as elderberry stands, Palmer's golden bush scrub, purple needlegrass grassland, coastal cactus wren, intact oak woodlands, and waters of the United States and state. Biologists identify nearly 9 acres of oak woodlands on and within a 200-foot buffer of the project site. The majority of the woodlands are considered intact, meaning ecological functions remain. According to the Biological Constraints Appendix, these ecological functions include groundwater infiltration, shade, habitat, nutrient cycling, sequestering of carbon, and the stands are self-sustaining and regenerating. Oddly, the early environmental review documents put the wildlife movement area through the neighborhoods and roads. A drive along Hacienda Boulevard would easily reveal that the topography in these locations consists of steep slopes that animals don't use to move. Instead, they go to the canyons between the hills. The closest undeveloped canyons are at the project site. Los Angeles County adopted a significant ecological area, SEA, which designates lands in the county to be of high ecological importance, and therefore any use conversion from their natural state should be very limited. The site was incorporated into the SEA locations, but because the adoption of the ordinance came after the project application was submitted, the project was not evaluated against the SEA guidelines. Again, the nearly 4,000-acre Puente Hills Preserve, owned and managed by the Habitat Authority, are immediately adjacent to the proposed project expansion. This is of concern because of conservation principles around decreased function of the landscape due to habitat fragmentation from development and edge effect, the latter of which concludes that invasive plant species and other edge issues creep onto adjoining lands. So, the recently restored and preserved habitat will be in jeopardy with the construction and use of this property. The next brief section includes the status of the proposed expansion. The initial study, a precursor to the release of an environmental impact report, EIR, came out in October 2020. Discussions with the Los Angeles County Planning Department reveal the EIR release date is unknown, but could be at any time. When it is released, the public will have around 45 days to review and comment on the document. The last section of this presentation includes specific next steps you should consider as the public and environmental review process unfolds. There are three opportunities to get involved. 1. Request the LA County Planning Department notify you when the EIR is released. 2. After the EIR is released, provide substantive comments, and 3. Oppose the project due to its impacts on the wildlife corridor.